Dear students, today we are going to solve the questions of exercise 2.4. The first one is determine which of the following polynomials has x plus 1 a factor. That means we need to divide the given polynomial x cube plus x square plus x plus 1 by x plus 1 and find the remainder. If the remainder will be equals to 0, then x plus 1 is a factor of given polynomial. Now we can write, let polynomial px equals to x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. We can write x plus 1 will be a factor of px on dividing px by x plus 1 and remainder will 0. If the remainder will be 0, that means x plus 1 is a factor of px. We are using here factor theorem, because in factor theorem the remainder should be equals to 0. Now we need to divide the given polynomial by x plus 1. X cube plus x square plus x plus 1. Very simple division. We need to find x cube here by multiplying given polynomial. That means in rough work we should think about how to get x cube by multiplying x plus 1 with any term. That means we need to multiply x plus 1 by x square. That means x square multiplied by x plus 1 is equals to x square multi x equals to x cube plus x square multiplied by 1 is x square. Now we can write x cube plus x square, and we should write x square is quotient, because the multiplication of quotient and divisor is can be written at here. Now in the procedure of division, we should subtract the given terms from given polynomial. X cube minus x cube, x square minus x square, that means it is equals to 0. Now the next term can be written as next dividend, x plus 1. X plus 1 is divided by x plus 1 one time, because x plus 1 multiplied by 1 equals to x plus 1. Therefore we can write x plus 1 here, and 1 is quotient. By subtracting these terms we can write remainder equals to 0. Here you have to note the remainder is 0. That means we can write x plus 1 is a factor of px. Now we need to write, therefore x plus 1 is a factor of polynomial x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. In other method we can use the remainder theorem, and we should find the remainder directly without division. For that we can write x plus 1 equals to 0, divisor should be equals to 0, and the value of x equals to minus 1. We can write by substituting value of x into given polynomial, then that value is directly equal to remainder. Then by remainder theorem, remainder p minus 1 equals to p minus 1, that means minus 1 cube plus minus 1 square plus minus 1 plus 1 equals to minus 1 cube is minus 1, minus 1 square is plus 1, minus 1 plus 1, that means plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 equals to 0. Remainder is 0, therefore we can write x plus 1 is a factor of px. Okay dear students, if we want to verify the x plus 1 is a factor of given polynomial or not, then we can use the factor theorem or remainder theorem. If we are using factor theorem, then we have to divide the given polynomials just like this. And if we want to find the remainder without division, then we have to use the second method. You can use both of two methods in your solution. Now you have to solve the questions 3rd, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, or 1st in your notebook with the help of remainder theorem directly without using factor theorem. Because we are using factor theorem in question number 2nd, you can clearly understand. Question number 2nd, use the factor theorem to determine whether gx is a factor of px in each of the following cases. Then we have to divide the given polynomial px by gx and find the remainder. If the remainder will 0, then gx is a factor of px. Now we are writing px and gx and dividing these polynomials. Px equals to 2x cube plus x square minus 2x minus 1 and gx equals to x plus 1. Now we are solving the questions. 2x cube plus x square minus 2x minus 1 is divided by x plus 1. Now we should think about which term is multiplied by x plus 1, and the term will be 2x cube. Then x plus 1 multiplied by x equals to x square plus x, therefore we have to multiply it by x square to get x cube. Now we can write x cube plus x square, but we have to find 2 in the coefficient of x cube, therefore we have to multiply the given term 2x square by x plus 1. The 2x square multi x is 2x cube plus 1 is 2x square. Now the division quotient is 2x square, and 2x cube plus 2x square can be written as. Now watch it carefully. Subtract these terms. 2x cube, 2x cube cancel. Now here plus x square minus 2x square. That means plus x square minus 2x square. Minus 2 plus 1 is minus 1x square. Now we can write minus x square, and next term is minus 2x. Now we should get minus here by multiplying any term to x plus 1. Then here is plus, and we need to find the minus at here. Now we should multiply it by minus x plus 1. Then x plus 1 is multiplying by any number with sign minus x square, that means x. It will be equals to minus x multi x is minus x square, and the other one is minus x. Now we should divide the term by minus x. and minus x square minus x. By subtracting these terms, we have to change the signs in plus. Now it is minus x square plus x square is cancelled. Here minus 2x plus x, it is converted in plus x. Minus 2x plus 1x is equals to minus 1x, that means minus x. It is equals to minus x, and the last one is minus 1. Here is minus, and the given gx is in plus, therefore we should write minus. X plus 1 is multiplying by minus 1 is minus x minus 1. That's why we can write minus 1 as quotient and minus x minus 1 at here. Now change the signs, plus plus, minus x plus x cancel, minus 1 plus 1 cancel, and the remainder is 0. Okay dear students, you have to watch the solution of this question twice, thrice to understand clearly the division of polynomial with the help of a linear polynomial. Very simple division, you have to try to understand. If you have any problem, then ask to me. Here the question, in this question the remainder is 0, therefore we can write because remainder equals to 0, therefore the given gx equals to x plus 1 is a factor of given polynomial px equals to 2x cube plus x square minus 2x minus 1. Very simple question. Now in the question number 3, we have given that find the value of k if x minus 1 is a factor of px in each of the following cases. The first one is px equals to x square plus x plus 1. In the question number 3, we have given px equals to x square plus x plus k, and we have also given x minus 1 is a factor of px. Here we have to know, if a linear polynomial is a factor of px, then on dividing px by x minus 1, the remainder should be equals to 0. Here we should have used the remainder theorem in this question, because we know very well, if the dividing by x minus 1, the polynomial's remainder is 0, then we can write x minus 1 equals to 0 to get the value of x, x equal to 1. By substituting value of x into px, then we'll get the value of remainder directly equals to 0, because we have given x minus 1 is a factor. Therefore px, then we can write remainder equals to 0 by using remainder theorem. Now remainder, that means p1 equals to 0. Now substituting the value of x equals to 1, 1 square plus 1 plus k equals to 0, then 1 square is 1 plus 1 plus k equals to 0, and 1 plus 1 is 2 plus k equals to 0. Now we can write k equals to minus 2. It is very simple. Okay dear students, the remaining questions of 3rd, 2nd, 3rd and 4th of question number 3, you can solve in your notebook. If you have any problem, then ask to me. The question number 4 and 5 will be discussed in the next videos. Keep watching the videos and keep continue your study.